majorly Jiji operating in the classifieds niche. What is classifieds? This is the type of marketplace where users, sellers can easily post their products online. I would call it hassle-free, without any problems. They can get their products online even within one day, and mostly they get their products sold same way online to the end users. So we don't become any kind of middleman. We don't collect any kind of commissions from our users. They sell their products straightly to the hands to the end users. That's why that kind of type of marketplaces is very efficient in Kenya and in Africa in general, because users, they want to save their costs, they want to gain as much profits as it possible from their goods, and the only way to do it is to avoid the middleman and to sell it straightly to the end customer. COVID-19 made a huge push in our industry. If we are talking about the world in general, classifieds business has grown up to 2 times during the COVID-19 pandemic. And we are in that industry, so definitely we has grown. We has grown in number of new customers, we has grown in number of the products, and also we has grown in revenue. So definitely, if we comply that the good product in a good time, in the right place, made the things happen. As I told you, initially we has grown. What's interesting that the number of active users currently in Kenya, I would say around 5 million unique active users every month. If we are talking of the number of sellers, it's more than 100,000 sellers across all Kenya sell something online. It can be different products, different categories. I mean, I told you initially that we are the horizontal marketplace. So we have the cars, we have properties, we have electronics, mobile phones, fashion products, and others. Definitely some categories are performing better than others because of some reasons. For example, we've seen the huge increase on the electronics demand and supply on our platform just only because of the pandemic of the COVID-19, and just only because of the huge demand on computers, laptops, on mobile phones, right? Because users has moved to the digital world much faster than it should have happened. Kenyan market is one of the most digitalized markets in Africa, which makes our work easier, right? We don't come and explain to users on why and how they're supposed to use this or that product, right? They already know it. They've been using it for several years. Kenyans know how to pay online. Kenyans know what is your wallets, right? So what is our job here is to make the experience a bit better. We are not introducing a new product to Kenyans. Kenyans already adjusted themselves to digital world. It was very unexpected for us, and I would say that we didn't really change the operations in case of our product. The product remained the same. We've seen some ups and downs in our analytics on the way our sellers and buyers behave. We've seen the move in users' behavior and customer journey in general, right? We've seen that basically most of our sellers has reduced the number of products they listed on the platform for several reasons. It was no stock, it was issues with deliveries and logistic companies, right? It was no money to buy new stock, right? No one expected the pandemic to come. But in general, why we've grown so far, just only because we've seen the extreme growth of new users coming to Jiji, right? So I would say like for 1 or 2 months, users were adjusting, and we definitely saw the drop in number of ads. But in 1-2 months, everyone has adjusted. They brought a new stock. They probably got some finances from banks or microfinance companies, and they restocked. They started using Jiji even more.
What of the last year?
I would say the third and the fourth quarter of the last year. Yes. And in general, we've seen the growth of the new users database and number of sellers. Actually, it's doubled. So I would say that the drop was just only for 1 month for us, when it was unexpectable environment, right? No one knew what will happen. In different countries, it passed differently. I would say that in Kenya, we passed it in the best possible way, just only because it was no strict lockdown measures, like in any other country, if we would say Uganda, for example, or Nigeria, right? It was much more stricter, of course, according to the COVID-19 rate and everything, right? We are moving into the car business way faster than we are moving in general. We just acquired recently the Cars 45 business. So we'll be able to create a definitely new experience for our car buyers and car sellers on Jiji. We will make sure that majority of our cars will be inspected on Jiji. So whenever you will buy a car, it will be a trusted decision to Jiji, right? So later on, we will decide to move into the property business a bit deeper, right? And it's not a fast process. It will take time, but as I'm trying to say, there is so many unexplored opportunities inside our business. Once we explore it fully and we make sure that in every single category we have done the best possible of ourselves, we will start exploring the new business. It was one of the biggest problems since we started our business, and not just only the problems on the product side. We have decreased the number of scammers up to almost to zero, right? And we currently can say that Jiji is free of scammers. But you know, like, Kenyans has some perceptions, and Kenyans don't have a lot of trust to e-commerce and online platforms in general, which makes our operations a bit harder than it can be, right? We should definitely say that Jiji is totally new, brand new platform, which is not OLX anymore, right? Jiji is not an OLX. Jiji has acquired OLX 2.5 years ago from Naspers Group, right? And Jiji operates totally different. Kenyans has some perceptions, and Kenyans don't have a lot of trust to e-commerce and online platforms in general, which makes our operations a bit harder than it can be, right? We should definitely say that Jiji is totally new, brand new platform, which is not OLX anymore, right? Jiji is not an OLX. Jiji has acquired OLX 2.5 years ago from Naspers Group, right? And Jiji operates totally different. In general, what is different with Jiji? Jiji is a localized e-commerce company which ensures that each and every single country has its own product, customer support, restrictions, anti-scam measures in place, right? So what's interesting that since we acquired OLX, we decreased the number of scammers up to 10 times, just only because we know this market and we use our local expertise, and we use our local people. We use different facilities to understand the market better, mm-hmm. right? So if I would say now for Jiji is much, much more difficult to scam anyone than it was like 3 or 4 years before with other companies. Our subscriptions allow you to, first of all, to post unlimited products, up to unlimited products. A subscription allows you to promote the selected items that you want in the better way, to promote it a bit more than usual items. And I would say that our prices are currently very, very reliable and comfortable for Kenyan users. I would say that since we started the subscription model and monetization, it was 1.5 years ago, just before the COVID-19 started, our prices were very extremely low, and we are not ready to increase it considering the current situation in the market, right? Let's say after maybe a year or 2 years, we would see on the market situation. If the market will adjust and normalize, we would definitely want to increase our price. But currently, we see that the market is low and we keep our prices also. Actually, the last fund, it was the round, we closed the round C. In 2019, by that time we get around $21 million, and I believe with the new acquisition of Cars 45, sooner or later we'll have to raise another round, definitely. But currently we are good with our operations. In Nigeria we are profitable, in Kenya we are almost profitable company, right? So definitely, if we decide to explore the market more and to get deeper in some categories and to create a totally new customer experience, for example, to dig deeper into the cars category and to create a transactional model as we are doing now, definitely we'll have to raise some money.